your other brothers and sisters in the Dhamma and in the Sangha to ensure that the blessings that you receive today will help you to carry on your good work in the years ahead. We know that you've not been well in the last couple of years, but I guess there's a saying that I picked up recently, which I think you all should also remember. They say that age is all in your mind. The trick is keeping it from crawling down your body. Achieve greater things in the years ahead. So on behalf of all the devotees of the Buddhist Mahavihara, let me take this opportunity to wish you long life and especially good health to carry on your good work many years more here at the Buddhist Mahavihara and here in Malaysia. I would also like to take this opportunity to thank all the members of the Mahasangha from all the different sects and also to our friends from
the chance of speaking a few words on behalf of Venerable Dhammaratana, who has been chief here and also the chief of Malaysia in a way, and also his birthday and also that. And here, he's a person who felt the situation and he didn't move. Just as a rock, when the wind blows, the rock doesn't move at all. And in the same way, he was a person who showed me how to fare.
Well, the Mahasangha gave devotees in order to offer food and other things to the Mahasangha, this will be one to me. Imam Vikram
kijk dan. Wat? Wat heeft dan dit gewoon?
And for now, I'd like to invite Venerable Chief and His Eminence Sam Rinpoche. As we know, on this occasion, His Eminence Sam Thoku Rinpoche would like to offer a gift to Chief. It is a 3-foot Sakyamuni statue. It is a token of Rinpoche's appreciation for the Chief's work in Malaysia to spread and promote the Buddha Dharma.
When I received the invitation from Sri Dhamma Ratana, the first thought that came to my mind was I was highly honored. Whether it were Sri Lankan Buddhists or were Chinese Buddhists or Tibetan Buddhists, what holds seniority in rank is not our hierarchy or our titles. It is more the age of the monk. The monk who has taken vows first. So by that right, the chief reverend here is much more senior to me. So when he gives me an invitation, it would be very rude for me to refuse by code of the IA.
当然后接受到张道的一个邀请的时候呢，他觉得在这场的邀请提到就是说，如果我们再以一个辈分来说，并不是说一个人的一个名称或者是任何的一个职位，而是说这个僧人他从实践所所见或者接受戒的一个年纪的长长或短，所以以这个情况来说呢，张道的。 以提早比较早熟持戒，持的戒也比较早，虽然辈分呢是比较高，所以而且仁波切也有提到，就是说如果以长者长老呢来，就说一个邀请仁波切，如果不来的话呢，其实是觉得是非常的不好意思。
According to the monk vows, the Vinaya given to us by Lord Buddha, seniority is when you took ordination first. So I was very honored to sit next to Venerable. And also this very holy venerable next to me, who's from USA, 80 years old, and had the blessings to be able to speak a few words with venerable.
所以呢，在佛教的礼情况呢，辈分呢，就是说是属于先受戒，所以以这一点，这里呢，我其实非常荣幸能够坐在长老很有资深的一个长老的旁边呢，然后一起再出席这样子的一个仪式。
According to Shakyamuni's doctrine, we have three objects of refuge, the Buddha, the Dharma, and the Sangha. Within the three objects of refuge, the Sangha who holds their vows, the Sangha who performs the work of benefiting others, the Sangha who accepts offerings and dana from the laity, performs the acts of generating merit for the benefit of the growth of Dharma.
在根据佛陀的这个教法呢，有三个主要的皈依对象，就是佛法跟僧。僧团呢的一个主要的情况就是借力实现在这个世间，让大家能够有机会呢，能够接触这个佛法，而且能够让大家有一个机会来制造更多的一些福德福田。
Whether we study or whether we meditate, or whether we do prayers for the fulfillment of attainments, for the fulfillment of enlightenment, the same as our Lord Buddha. Very crucial is the collection of merit. When we collect merit, when we generate merit, and we dedicate this to the highest of the high, which is full enlightenment, then we have hope to leave samsara, and at the same time, to save others out of samsara. So the root of all of that, very important for lay people and for sangha, is the collection of merits.
不管在我们追求任何的那些所谓的愿望，就是在证悟、求道等等之类的那个路上呢，最重要的一点就是能够积德，就是能够得到更多的福报。当我们有很多的功德、福德的时候呢，能够帮助我们能够更久的达到。所以，不管在任何一种情况下，当我们得到一种非常广大的一个福德跟功德的时候呢，然后我们并且把这个回向于让我们能够得到证悟的利益，其实这一方面呢是非常的重要的。
The Sangha, the third of the three jewels, works tirelessly. How do they work tirelessly? The true Sangha, such as Chief Venerable, holds their vows. They restrict themselves from entertainment, from marriage, from making money, from enterprises that ordinary lay people can enjoy. So they sacrifice their personal happiness, their personal short-term happiness, by holding on to the vows. Then they enter into the Sangha order to study, such as our Venerable Chief here, to learn the teachings of the Dharma, to understand the teachings of the Dharma, and to hold the teachings of the Dharma. Then by holding the teachings of the Dharma, when students request such a esteemed Sangha member to teach, the esteemed Sangha member teaches, turning the wheel of the Dharma. So the Sangha works tirelessly their whole lives by holding the vows and sacrificing their own short-term graspings. At the same time, they study the Buddha's teachings, they understand the Buddha's teachings, and they practice. And third, when students request out of compassion for others to be relieved out of samsara, the Sangha will turn the wheel of Dharma as best they can. So that way, when we revere and respect the Sangha, like you all have done here, I rejoice from my heart sincerely. I feel very happy for everyone here, from my heart.
一个僧人通过持戒，通过学习佛法，通过研习了解佛法，护持这个佛法，就如长老一般。他们呢，在护持佛法过后呢，信众就要求这些僧人来转法。当这个法轮在转的时候呢，就知道一个机会，让大家能够离开这个娑婆世界，能够得到一个证悟。所以，像长老呢，这位尊敬的长老，他受戒。 持戒、学习佛法、了解佛法，并且不持这个佛法，在经过所有的当下所有这些的人在祈求佛法的时候呢，从一开始转法轮的时候，每个人就有机会能够得到离开娑婆世界、samsara的一个机会。所以这个在此呢，他的人们看到在大家不是这样做呢，他觉得非常的欢喜，非常的开心，他也非常开心，大家能够这样做。
So when we come today to celebrate the birthday of a monk, it's not like a normal celebration. Maybe some people book a room in McDonald's, have some balloons, I hope not, have some balloons, share some presents, blow some music. That one's very normal. That's nothing much. But when we come here to celebrate the birth of a Sangha member who works tirelessly for others, then celebrating, working, cleaning, preparing, doing work for the birthday of a Sangha member is not an ordinary act. It is an act of Dharma. Why? You revere the Sangha, therefore you celebrate the birth of a great Sangha member. So today when we come here and we celebrate Chief's birthday, it is not a simple gesture. It is a celebration. We thank the Buddhas for having Chief here. We thank Chief for choosing the path of Dharma to benefit all of us. So we are celebrating his work, his decision, and his renunciation.
当我们来出席一个僧人的一个生日的时候呢，并不像一般的一些世界上的活动。
当我们对有些人或许会在麦当劳里面有一个派对，能够吹一些气球等等。可是，在我们今天呢，来庆祝这个像这位长老的生日的时候呢，所以不管在之前的预备工作、清洁、准备等等之类的，并不是一般事情的活动，而是一个佛法的一个行动。所以在此呢，当我们在这里庆祝呢，是庆祝这个长老持戒，并且放弃了，就是生出出离心，忘记世间一些东西，持戒守戒，并且传佛法。我们在此为他而庆祝，并且来感谢他。
I took ordination when I was 23 years old in 1987 from His Holiness the 14th Dalai Lama. I traveled from the United States, went to India, and became a monk. Why so late? My parents wouldn't allow me to become a monk earlier.After that, I entered the Great Gandhi Monastery to study. After that, I was sent abroad to teach by my abbots, Kepchi Rati Maharshi. So here I am in Malaysia teaching the Dharma. Why am I telling you my history? Because teaching the Dharma in a different setting than your own setting is a great challenge. It's a huge challenge from above, below, and middle east.And I know the challenges that I have gone through to teach the Dharma and the different types of difficulties that I had to endure. Hence, I know that more than me, I am sure Reverend Chief Monk here has endured much more. Therefore, when I see this soul, when I see this monk here, I can relate to what he must go through. Everything here looks nice and simple and easy, but behind the scenes, I am sure Chief gets very little sleep.And works very hard, like most Sangha who teach. So I am very rejoiceful to see you here together.
仁波切呢，其实在1987年，在23岁的时候呢，受戒于十四世的达赖喇嘛，然后到了之后呢，他是从美国，然后去到了印度，然后才之后呢，由至尊那提仁波切就是住持的。的情况下，他来到了马来西亚。所以仁波切呢，之前受戒是来受戒于至尊十四世的至尊达赖喇嘛受戒，是受那个沙弥戒。所以仁波切从那个时候就去到了印度旦旦寺去学修习，然后直到了至尊那提仁波切的请求下，就要仁波切只是来到马来西亚传法。所以为什么仁波切要给让大家知道他的一些背景呢？这是因为当一个僧人到一个不同的一个区域、一个地区，在传法的时候呢，所遇到的一些困难是非常的大。那种不管是在上、中、下各种不同的一种传法的状况呢，都会遇到很多困难。所以呢，仁波切能够深深感受到长老从多年以前来到马来西亚传法的那种辛苦，那种这里看到穷途是那么的美丽、那么的简单、那么的开心。可是，在背后呢，相信仁波切相信长老呢。非常的少的休息，而且非常的努力，致力的把佛法在这个地方、这个国土把它发扬光大。
So today, from my heart, I would like to offer the universal monarch, the Tathagata Buddha Shakyamuni, to Reverend, and I request Reverend to please bless me, please bless all my students here, please bless all of us who wish to do Dharma, that we may be like him.Courageous in spreading the Dharma. And today, by offering a Buddha statue to a senior monk, I also collect the Great Mount of Merit. And I dedicate this, the Mahavira, and all Dharma organizations throughout Malaysia and the world may grow, may increase, and may the Sangha forever become successful in their work.
在此呢，借此机会呢，仁波切长在这里呢，把这个宇宙世间的佛陀把它供养给长老。那在此呢，因为我们也希望请求长老能够加持仁波切，加持我们所有这里的学生、所有的人，能够让我们能够得到一些证悟。而且同时在供养这个佛陀给长老的时候呢，仁波切也说他也积到了很多的福德，所以他想要把这个福德回向给所有在座的人，所有的人能够得到很好的一个修行上的进步，而且回向给所有的僧人，希望你们所有的佛法事业能够一切的顺利，继续的发扬光大。
So please excuse me for giving a small Dharma talk when I'm when there are so many senior monks abroad here, it is very disrespectful of me. I do not mean any disrespect. Please excuse me. This is my Vinaya code.
这里呢，仁波切想要向大家就是说，祈求一个原谅，因为给了一个短短的一个开始。其实，在座这里呢，有其他的更多更多年长的一些僧人可以给予开始。可是，在此呢，想要跟大家就说一个况且开始。
Birthday celebration, but immediately when I left.
the news. I had cancer and I went back to Sri Lanka and I had my duty towards the my beloved nation.
And of course I know our beloved teacher, Venerable Dr. K.C. Ramananda, and beloved my mother, is definitely giving me blessing and guiding me to continue my life for the next time. And today, in Sri Lanka, my family also organizing the memorial service, 1 year memorial service. At the same time, my family in Malaysia, all my Buddhist brothers and sisters and uncles and aunties together, all my brother monks and sisters and together, we are going to transfer melody my beloved mother. So whether I'm in Sri Lanka or here, so there's no difference because to do good things, there's no fixed place, no fixed time, anytime we can do it for the other, eight masters at all. So now, wherever monks together, our devotees has organized this dance ceremony. I personally would like to say big thanks to all the Venerable monks being present over here, being in us with me together to transfer merit to my beloved mother. At the same time, to remember my birthday. So, birth is Vedic. Talking about birth. So, at the same time, the next birth is the death. So, when you come to this world, and suppose one fine day, we have to leave this world, and until that, we are getting more and more realizing the Dhamma, realizing the nature of life. At the same time, you must try to contribute ourselves to the mankind. And within my capacity, I am really happy to contribute to the, I'm really happy to contribute to the society, to the mankind. But of course, I can't perform miracles. I can't perform many things, but within my capacity, I try my best to contribute to the society. And come back to the Malaysia. Malaysia is a multiracial, multi-religious country. And concerning about the Buddhism, we are very fortunate. In this country, first religion is Islam. Second religion is the Buddhism. And Buddhism in Malaysia is a little bit complicated compared with the other Buddhist countries because we have the many way of practice. But I have to remind you, during Buddha's time, there was no so-called this tradition, that tradition, only Buddha's tradition. After he passed away, only we start to segregate. But remember, basic teachings in the state. Whether Buddha came from this mountain or that mountain, but it still goes to the same seed. Same way, my dear brothers and sisters in the town, today we can see more than
CTO Venerable Mahan Sadhana. On behalf of the Buddhist Mahavihara, on behalf of the management committee, and on behalf of the, our resident man, on behalf of my beloved mother, I really appreciate your presence over here. I have no words to explain to say thank you. It can carry on. But when Balmang and Lamas, this is a high time for us to be united. Whether we came from China or India or USA or Sri Lanka or Thailand or Myanmar, but we are all our Buddha's children. We must be united. We cannot be ego. We cannot be just selfish. We all work together. Be united. We must not segregate. I am belong to Mahayana tradition, or Theravada tradition, or Vajrayana tradition. We must try our best to forget all these traditions. We must work as the Buddha's children. When we work as the Buddha's children, we will be able to be strengthened ourselves, and we will be able to contribute to the society easily. If we are going to segregate, if we are going to criticize and comment about each other or not, we are getting weaker and weaker. Remember, we have to open our eyes, work together. You need any help and assist, please don't be hesitant to contact me. Come forward and we can discuss anything, any miscommunication, any misunderstanding if we have. If we can communicate, we will be able to find solution. We will be able to propagate our great master's teaching. And myself, I am trying my best to come forward to bring all of us together and work together as our great master's children and venerable monks and nuns. So this is not time for me to give you a long sermon, and I humbly appeal to each and every one of you. When we are together, we must treat each other as our own brothers and sisters, because we are our great master's children. And I hope one of these days we bring together, now how nice, you can see so many little monks and nuns. You can see from mainland China monks available, from Thailand, from Tibet, from Nepal, from Myanmar, from Sri Lanka. So how beautiful. This is not important for King from Mataku Maroks Vihari. But important is our great master's teaching. All the venerable monks and nuns, we sacrifice ourselves. And today we are here under the one roof as a whole in as a one family. So I hope one of these days we get together and discuss our problems and difficulties and to improve ourselves. What do we, if one mental month he or she doesn't have any things or any need, they need any assistance, we are ever ready to come forward to help. We can discuss each other. So I humbly appeal to all of you, please come forward and we work together. Not only come for the dana or chanting or sermon, So we must sit down and discuss and find a solution and find the way how to propagate the Dharma. We don't have to go against the Dharma, we don't have to go against the other people. Sometimes most of our people used to comment and criticize how these people are losing. Actually, we must not blame other people. We must blame our own self. So, please, you all must try the best way to teach the Dharma to our devotees and make them learn the Dharma, make them understand the Dharma, make them practice the Dharma. Then, if they can learn the Dharma, if they can understand the Dharma, if they can practice the Dharma, definitely we can find peace and harmony in this world. And with these few words, once again, I would like to say big thanks to all the veterans, especially our Rinpoche. And he has been inviting me to go for lunch, but unfortunately, I did not have enough time. I'm almost 22 hours running here and there. I'm supposed to be here 11 o'clock, before 11, but I didn't say by 11:45. But one fine day again, I hope to meet our Rinpoche, and I personally would like to say big thanks to our Rinpoche and his devotees, but even for the Buddha statue, Buddha image, the Rupa, the us. And to remember the great master's teaching. And all the venerable monks are here. I really appreciate the presence here once again, six stars for all of you. And again, I would like to say thank you to all the management from the Buddhist Mahavihar, all the devotees and volunteers, and whoever come over to participate in this celebration, memorial service as well as the birthday celebration. But you are celebrating my birthday, being reminding me again and again. So my time is getting closer and closer. I'm getting younger and younger, and again getting wiser and wiser. And as you know, last year and previous years, as well as me, I have gone through so much tough time. Even today, I'm sitting over here with one eye, one ear. But still, I'm trying my best to contribute my service to our Buddhist community, generally for our country. So, with this few words, once again, I would like to say, for each and every one of you, I really, really, really say big thanks and big salu to all of you being participating for our memorial service for my mother, as well as participating for my birthday celebration, 63. And this morning also celebrated. I have been celebrating last 1 week and today. And this morning, on Christmas, the birthday party celebration, and again 9:30, 1,005 students together. I celebrate my birthday now, and later I'm going to celebrate with 10 people, those who cannot hear, cannot talk. They also want to celebrate with me, and then tonight again, another group of people. So, but I know you will really appreciate my work, and once again, I really would like to wish with this strong marriage and by the power of the Buddha, Dhamma and Sangha, may all of us find peace, happiness and good health and long life. And 欢迎你，比如我很欢迎你在英雄那块历史啊。
Thank you.